people.
Hello there.
Hope y'all are all having a fantastic day today. We got the MTV Unplugged version, which is hands down the best thing MTV has ever produced in their entire life, of Alice in Chains performing Rooster.
Yeah!
Now, we have checked out Rooster before on the channel. That was a long time ago, and that was a studio version. I wanted to check out today's video because I heard from countless Hefners that this was such a haunting live performance. Now, this session took place 6 years before Lane Staley had passed away.
The lead singer of the rock band Alice in Chains has been found dead in his Seattle home.
How he passed away was tragic, dude. An overdose, speedball, cocaine and heroin at the same time, okay? And it's super crazy, dude, because Lane Staley's body was found 2 weeks after his death. His body was just laying on the couch. And I wanted to dive into this because it seems to be such a haunting performance that I wanted to check it out. You know, the very first time around, we learned that the lyrical content of this song was written about Jerry Cantrell's father, who was in the military. One of two stories, right? He was nicknamed Rooster. That's where the song came from. Or alternatively, the Vietnamese didn't know what the bald eagle was, so they oftentimes called it the rooster or the chicken, right? So it doesn't get better than this. Link to the original video will be down below in the description. Y'all make sure to check it out if you want to. Hope y'all are all taking care and brushing your hair. Heard that on TikTok. Let's get it, man. Already, initially, without even a spoken lyric, they're creating this atmospheric tone, this really earthy tone that is darkness, but at the same time, it's beauty, right? So it's a very strange combination that we're introduced to right away in the song. Very cool. God, dude. Now that we're listening to the song in retrospect, it allows us to listen to it through a different lens, and we take something away from that was very different from the initial time that we listened to it, okay? The very first time was more about that war aspect, that military aspect, that paying homage to Jerry's father aspect. Nowadays, we're looking at it through the lens of Lane being lost and passing on already. We're looking at it through that lens, and you get a lot from it. Going into a song with different mindsets, that's the really intricate thing about music, that depending on how your mood is when you go listening to a song, you get a very different message from it. It's something that's really intriguing. Crazy how the brain works like that. Wife and kids, household pet, army dreams, no safe bed. That smile exchange is real cool. It's good energy. The bullets scream to me. It's crazy, dude, because he doesn't necessarily look good here. He doesn't look healthy. He sounds absolutely incredible. Just out of this world, insane. With the grain to his voice and the texture to it, he creates this sandpaper-like feel that you just really embody and understand. You feel the grittiness about it. But he just looks, his eyes look sunken in and dark, and he looks like unwell, right? Crazy that that pure of a sound came from what looks like a deteriorating person, right? Yeah, they come to snuff the rooster. That's so interesting. That's a very different smile. Jerry, you know, I commented on the smile the first time around. When Jerry's looking at different members of the band, it's almost got a different, like, spark to the smile. When he's looking at Lane just then, it's like almost a smile of concern. It's very fun to overanalyze and really kind of maybe make something that it's not, but that's kind of what I'm getting from that, is the different tonalities of the smile, right? The different energy that it carries. Very bizarre. Here come the rooster. That was weird. Is it me, or does it look absolutely effortless to him? Doesn't look like he's trying. Doesn't look, it's just, he's got like that God-given ability. Everything else, everything is so on point in this song. Everything. Something I love about this song. You gotta give Jerry props though. His backup vocals to Lane, perfect. The perfect fit. That fluctuation in he, that he, it's... You know what I really appreciate about this song is the simplicity of it. It doesn't sound very intricate. It doesn't sound super complex to play. People don't have to be extraordinarily proficient in their instrument and abilities to play this song, but there's a spark there to it. There's so much emotion and feeling with this song that it's hard to replicate. It's like there's complexity in the simple, or there's simplicity in the complex. However you look at that, it kind of paints this picture. In my mind, there's a complex simplicity about it. Weird, right? But that's kind of... what it, the vibe that I'm getting. Some machine gun man, they spit on me in my homeland. Gloria sent me pictures of that guitar. Insane. Yes. Got my pills against mosquito. I love these MTV Unplugged versions, dude. It is the hands down greatest thing MTV has ever done. Oh God, please, won't you help me make it through? One of the most incredible vocalists, dude. Here they come to stop the rooster. He looks out of it, dude. Something about him, he looks out of it, man. Yeah, here comes the rooster. Yeah. You know he ain't gonna die. No, no. You know he ain't gonna die. It hits differently hearing that. No, he ain't gonna die. It's like, while he seems, he's actually fighting for his life, you know? Comes back full circle to that haunting beauty at the very end. Oh my God, dude.
Those people that are watching it live have no idea what they're actually seeing.
They don't know how lucky they are, dude. And listening to that song, it's eerie. It makes me almost borderline uncomfortable. Like I said, him singing that, and we get something different from the song because we're looking at it through a completely different lens. And there are multiple different ways that I still don't understand and will never be able to relate to this song. Listening to it through the lens of intense drug abuse, right? I'm not a drug addict. I don't have that ability. So for someone who's been through that, for them to hear the song and hear those lyrics, which may mean one thing while they were writing it, but something else in the position that we're in now, it really would probably hit so deep. And that being said, another type of lens that I'm talking about that you can listen to this song through that I will never be able to understand is listening to it through the context of a military personnel, somebody who's been through battle, been engaged in warfare, been in the military. I'll never truly be able to experience the song from that lens. So if you guys have been through either drug abuse, drug addiction, or in the military, what is that like? Drop some comments down below. I'd be really interested to find that out. Unbelievable song, man. One of the absolute greatest musicians of our time. Fuck, dude. I cannot stop coming back to these MTV Unplugged, so if you got any others that you want me to check out, please drop them down below in the comments. And with that being said, keep smiling, keep being yourself, don't let anybody throw shade at you. I will see you guys tomorrow. That's a motherfucking fact, though. Yeah, love y'all. Peace!